To be grounded in your word. As we start 2020, I commit my thoughts to your word. I ground my thoughts to focus on your word. I pray that you give clarity. For we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Just say amen. Then the Lord answered and said, light and vision. Somebody say vision. Then the Lord answered to me and said, write the vision and make it plain on tablets. Write the vision in this year 2020 and make it plain on a tablet that he may learn who reads it. Amen? Amen. And verse number 3, this is a word for somebody already in this house. Verse number 3 says, and I want you to receive it. Verse number 3 goes ahead and says, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. Somebody say appointed time. But at the end it will speak. What gonna speak? What gonna speak? What gonna speak? The vision will speak. At the end it will speak. And it will not do what? It will not lie. Amen. At the end, somebody, the vision will speak and it will not lie. Though it tarries. Come on, somebody. Though it tarries. Though your supernatural harvest in 2019 did not come through, it may tarry. It's still in the ground. Amen. Though it tarries, wait for it. Amen. Woo. That's a hard word to speak. Wait for it. We live in a microwave generation that we do not know how to wait. But though it tarries, do what? Wait for it. Why are you going to wait for it? Wait for it because it will surely come to pass. Another word of God that says, it will surely come to pass. Amen. Amen. Is there something that you're trusting God for this year? As you start this new decade, is there something that you're trusting God for? Wait for it, for it will surely come to pass. It will not time. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. When you walked in that door, I'm sure most people are like, are we in the doctor's office or what's going on? Because you found that chart that you usually see at the doctor's office. Maybe some of you didn't see it. But if you saw it, we have a chart over there. And in the hospital, they call them Snellen chart. And those are the things that they use to see for the vision. When you go to the doctor, when you go to the DMV and you cannot pass your eye test, they send you back to the doctor. They tell you to go. Because what they are looking for is a perfect vision. And the perfect vision is 2020. Amen. If you don't have that perfect vision of 2020, if you have 220, you are what they call legally blind. You can drive, you can do things, you are told to go and look for prescription glasses. So 2020, year 2020, what the Lord is requiring for me and you to have is what we call a perfect vision. Amen? Amen. And if you don't have it, by God's grace, the Lord will take you through the process where you're going to get your prescription. And when you have your prescription, then you can come and stand and say, Pastor, from the back, and can be able to read these numbers here. Is there somebody who can read these numbers over here? Yes. If you cannot read them, by the end of this year, you'll be able to stand at the back there and read the number because the Lord will give you a 2020 vision. Amen. Praise the Lord. So what the Lord is doing in the spirit right now is giving the spirit of revelation. And on that chart that you saw over there, one of the things that the Lord said, that the closer you are to Jesus, the closer you are to Jesus, the clearer your vision becomes. And the problem that we have in the world today is we want to look more onto our own thinking. But the Lord is saying that if you want to see clearly, if you want to know what's going to happen in 2020, there's only one secret. You've got to be closer to Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. You've got to be closer to Jesus. People are looking for secret of success. People are looking for seminars. People are Googling on the web and everywhere looking, how can I succeed in life? How can I be a better person? Yes. As we start this decade, I am speaking a word over somebody that if you want to become a better husband, if you want to become a better father, if you want to become a better Christian, if you want to become a better neighbor, if you want to become a better co-worker, the only secret that you have to be is to be close to Jesus. Praise the Lord. Because when you're close to Jesus, your vision will become clear. Hallelujah. And the further you move away from Jesus, you start deviating from 2020, you go, some people you attend church today, the following Sunday you don't feel like coming to church, you sleep a little bit, you are moving away from Jesus, you started serving in the ministry, the following day you feel like you don't want to serve, you get closer to yourself, the more you are going away from Jesus, your vision, you are losing your vision. But the clearer you come to Jesus, the closer your vision and the closer your blessings you will receive in 2020. Amen? Amen? So every day when you come in, when you see that chart, I want you to look at that chart and I want you to look at in the spiritual realm and look and say, where I am, where am I spiritually? Amen? Praise the Lord. You can define yourself by looking at it and saying where you are spiritually. And the goal for this year, the goal for this century, is for you to be closer to Jesus. That you'll be able to achieve the greatness that Jesus has for you. Amen. That's from the church from outside. I'm laying a foundation for you. Then you come here, you see this chart over here that says 2020 will be the year of great vision. 2020. I know so many people, even when we came here for the Kesha, they were saying, Pastor, I still want to hang in into supernatural harvest. Amen? Which is a good thing. But I have a better news for you. Amen? For you, even with a supernatural harvest, the Lord wants you to have a greater vision. When you have a greater vision, supernatural harvest comes clearly. Why? Because the Lord will open your eyes that you may be able to see the supernatural harvest. When you have a vision, you can be able to see the treasures. Am I speaking a word for somebody? When you have a vision, clear vision, you can be able to see the hidden treasures. Amen?
Amen.
Somebody better receive that word. Amen. You have a vision, you'll be able to receive the hidden treasures. When your vision is broad, you cannot be able to receive the vision. Amen?
Amen.
So, on this chart over here, some of the things that the Lord will want us to work on this year, and some of this will still have to go them in details as the year goes. On this one here, you see focus. And that's all with a vision. When you have a focus, you can be able to see it. Amen? Turn to your neighbor and say, focus.
Focus.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Let your mind be focused over here. So when you have a focus, one of the things that the Lord wants you to work on the focus is your perception. Amen?
Amen.
Your perception, the way you see things. The Lord wants you to focus so much this year on the way you perceive things. So if you perceive the impossible, you can do the impossible. Praise the Lord. Amen. If you perceive the impossible, you can do the impossible. So the Lord wants you to focus on your perception. The Bible talks of the blind Bartimaeus, that when he heard that Jesus was passing by, even though he was blind, he had a perception and he perceived himself that begin to be able to see. And he cried and said, Jesus, have mercy on me. And everybody surrounding him could not see what he was seeing. He was blind, but he had a vision. But some people have eyes, but no vision. Maybe your eyes are open like mine. For me, I can see any kind of numbers. But the thing is, do I just need a sight or do I need a vision? 2020, the Lord wants you to have sight, and on top of the sight, the Lord wants you to have a vision. You visualize it. You see where you're going to be. You draw your line clearly and say, in 3 months, Lord, this is where I want to be. In 6 months, Lord, this is where I want to be. By the end of 2020, this is where I want to be. You see it, you visualize it. And when you perceive the impossible, you can do the impossible. Amen? Amen. And perception is not for the other people that are surrounding you. This is a personal message. Because with Bartimaeus, everybody surrounding him could not perceive it. They could not think, how are you crying? Why are you bothering the master? You are blind anyway. But he says, you see, the thing is, sometimes you lose your focus because of the people that are surrounding you. They may not see what you're seeing. So perception is a personal thing. And you have to focus in the year 2020. Praise the Lord. From perception, we'll be talking deeper in perception. Then from there, you won't have to focus on your spiritual growth. You have to focus on your spiritual growth this year. Not just coming to church and receiving the sermon and you go home. After church, you need to study the Bible. You need to have a habit of studying the Word of God. You need to look for every opportunity that you can be able to grow spiritually. Somebody say amen. Amen. And once you have the focus on your spiritual life, things surrounding you will automatically change in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Another thing for you to focus on this year, you need to focus on self-discipline. Amen. Amen. Ooh, amen. Amen. I know I may not receive a lot of amen on that one. But let me tell you, church, for us to be able to grow, for us to be able to get to where the Lord wants us to be, we got to have self-discipline. Amen.
Amen.
Some of you, the trouble that you went through in 2019 is because you're in the places where you're not supposed to be. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Some of the things that happened to you and you say, God, how come you didn't come and be praying? It's because you did not have self-discipline. But this year, I want you to have a self-discipline. Wherever you go, whatever you listen to, whatever you see, whatever you do, whatever you talk, whatever you do your things, you got to have a self-discipline as a Christian. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Even whatever you wear, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Can any of you have amen in this house?
Amen.
Because it is by the grace of God, the Lord wants you to have that self-discipline. And whatever you read, and whatever you post online, amen.
Amen.
Can I hear a bigger amen?
Amen.
Whatever you post on your Instagram, whatever you post on your Facebook, and I hear most people, they are not in Facebook anymore. When we were just trying to catch up with the generation, they all ran away from Facebook, they went to Instagram. And when you go to the Instagram, they run away from Instagram, they go to another one. It's very hard to catch up with this generation. But let me tell you, at the end of the day, whatever you leave, whatever you post, whatever you put over there, you got to have self-discipline. Amen? Can I hear a bigger amen from this?
Amen.
Amen. So that's very important for this decade. You know why? If the Lord is preparing you for greatness, you don't want to be prepared for greatness, and then by the time before your greatness comes, you are put down by all the posts that you've been posting on Instagram. I am preparing somebody for greatness in this house. I am preparing somebody who is ready to move forward. I'm preparing for somebody that will become, will hold a future and become a leader in Jesus' mighty name. I am preparing you for the decade. Hallelujah. I am preparing you for greatness. So you got to have self-discipline. The other thing that we're going to work on this year, we're going to focus so much on our mindset. Praise the Lord. Mindset. And when you talk about the mindset, it's the group of your mind, the set of your mind. And most of our mindset is sometimes influenced by our upbringing or the people that we hang out with and the things that we believe. Some of you have the mindset. You have some strongholds. What is a stronghold? A stronghold is a lie that you believe. A stronghold is a lie that you believe. Can you please defend to your neighbor on that word, because I want to talk something about the mindset. A stronghold is a mind, is a lie that you believe. Just explain to them. So a stronghold is a lie that you believe. Woo! Amen. When you have something that you believe, and you know it, and nobody can take you away from it, you believe it, but the matter of fact is a lie, that's a stronghold. There are some people in this house that believe so much that they have anger issues. You believe it. There are people who believe that they are shy. There are people who believe that they cannot do anything. And every time you talk to them, they say, this is who I am. There are people who say that, you know what? Okay, you guys preach whatever you're preaching, but this is me. This is me. That's a stronghold. And I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that in this year, every stronghold will be broken in Jesus' mighty name. Come on, somebody. Say, in Jesus' mighty name. Because when the stronghold is broken, when the stronghold is broken, your mindset will completely change. Amen? Amen. There are people who used to believe when we were in high school that I'm not good in math. And you say that in our family, nobody is good in math. That's a stronghold. Some people say that nobody graduated in my high school. You know, nobody have ever gone to campus in my family. And you believe it, you cannot go to campus. You cannot do things just because you have a stronghold. And some people say that nobody, my grandmother never got married. My mom never got married. Even me, I cannot get married. I cannot go to the aisle. That's a stronghold. Praise the Lord. And the Lord wanted this ticket for you to bring down that stronghold and break it in Jesus' mighty name. When the mindset will change, when the stronghold is broken. Amen? And it got to change your talk from talking about me and start talking about Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Some people, they are very good in me. Me, myself, I, and everything is all out. Me. It got to be broken in this year. Amen. It got to change because the Lord wants to change. The Lord cannot use you when you're all egocentric, thinking about yourself. The Lord wants you to change from you to Him because it's all about Jesus. Somebody give God some praise in this way. Amen. And by the end of this year, we're going to talk to this topic in details. Then from there, when you change your focus to that, when you have your focus, now this is going to be now about you. I'm not taking up everything about you completely. Amen. When you focus on God, the Lord will give you clarity. Amen. Because when you think about the new great vision, you're going to have a vision, then you're going to have a clarity. Then you can be able to see. So when you have a clarity, there are some things that are going to happen in your life. Number one, you'll be able to have financial breakthrough. And so many people that were so concerned about supernatural harvest being taken away from you. I have good news for you. Amen. You will have financial breakthrough because you'll be able to see clearly. Amen. You'll be able to see clearly things that God has in store for you. You'll be able to see clearly. Your eyes will be open. You'll be able to see opportunities. You'll be able to see treasures. You'll be able to see things that are hidden, what other people cannot be able to see. Amen? Is that a word for somebody in this house? Amen. You'll be able to see what others cannot see. Yes. Then you have a clarity to maximize your potential. Some people, they look at you and they don't see anything good in you. But let me tell you, once your mindset changes, once you have a focus, the Lord will help you to maximize your potential. Whatever you're going to do, you'll be able to do it in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't know where you see yourself. I don't know how you look at yourself. But this year, you'll be able to maximize your potential. I see greatness in this house. I see greatness in your life. And that is exactly what the Lord will do. He will activate that greatness in you, and you'll be able to maximize your potential. Then you'll be able to have healthy relationship. This will start from families. You have a very healthy family relationship. It will come to the spouses in this house. You have a very healthy man and wife relationship. It goes to your relationship with your children. It's going to be healthy. It's going to be a relationship with other people. You can be able to relate with others. And I pray and I bind the spirit of loneliness in this house. Amen. Some people are loners. They just want to be by themselves. A human being is a social being. Praise the Lord. Those people who want to isolate themselves, I bind that spirit in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. You cannot live by yourself. But you cannot live by yourself. You isolate yourself. You are putting yourself a suicide note. But I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that somebody will come out from that cocoon. Yes. Break that cocoon and be able to live and have healthy relationship in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Some of all you will say that I don't want to interact with the people because they're going to offend me. How many of you know you have offended? Praise the Lord. Go offend them and offend. And in the process of offending each other, you'll be able to know each other and have a healthy relationship. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. Can I hear a big amen for that one? Yeah, I'm so cautious, Pastor, you know. I don't like to interact with the people. Who are you? Praise the Lord. I don't like people to offend others. Go offend them. Amen. Let them offend you. You offend them. You get to know each other. In the process, you'll be a stronger person. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Isolating yourself does not solve any problem. 2020, I pray that the Lord will get you out from that isolation. Some of you, the reason that you're not married is because you've isolated yourself. How are you going to get your spouse? Amen. Let me leave it at that. Amen. So the next one will be good health. Amen. Because once you focus on everything, the Lord will make sure that you have that good health. Amen. Because some people, you are sick not because you have a diagnosis. You are sick because of the thing that you see online. Praise the Lord. You are sick because of the TV shows that you watch. May the Lord deliver you from those things that will drive you crazy. You wake up in the morning, you're on CNN, you're on Fox News, you're on every news media, and whatever comes in, it drives you crazy. Some people, they scratch their mind. You don't even want to go to work because of the news that you received. Oh, amen. And some of our brothers, they are also in the TV watching football and games and everything. You're so much attached. That even if your baby is running over there, you cannot see them because your mind is focused on that. May the Lord bless you. Amen. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord help you that you may have a healthy, a good health. Amen. Sometimes, do you know it's healthy for you to isolate yourself from all these things? Then you can have a very good health. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The politics was there even before you were born. Amen. Hallelujah. If you want me to prove it to you, go to the book of Job. You see, the Bible says that when Job, when Satan went over Job, the Bible says that God asked Satan, "Satan, where were you?" And Satan said, "No, I was just walking back and forth, back and forth in the water." And he said, "Have you seen? Have you seen my friend Job? You guys know about that one?" The Bible says that Satan was doing what? Walking what? Back and forth. In Greek word, walking back and forth is called political. And that's where the word politics comes from. Amen? So what Job was doing, he was politicking. What Satan was doing, he was politicking. And that's why the Lord says, "Have you considered my servant Job?" And some of you people who are into politics so much, the politics was there before you were born, when the time of Satan and Job, politics was still there. And my opinion and your opinion will not change anything. What it's going to do, it's going to mess up your relationship. It's going to mess up your health. So you're going to be delivered from the spirit of politics in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Only one amen in this house and it's okay. Praise the Lord. But the truth has to be communicated. So that's what's going to happen in this year, 2020. The Lord will give you clarity. Amen? And the Lord will make you focus. And the theme for this year is Habakkuk 2, from 2 to 3. And I'm going to tell you the prophecy that God told me. But before I tell you the prophecy, the book of Habakkuk has only 3 chapters. And on your own time, you can go read the book of Habakkuk. But what was happening with Habakkuk, he was one of the minor prophets. And our sister talked about how Nehemiah and Ezra were thinking about going to rebuild the temple. But I want you to know how the temple was destroyed. Before they thinking about rebuilding it, what my sister brought at the Hesha, the destroying, one the that temple for destroying is this time of Habakkuk. And the Bible says that Habakkuk was so mad with God. And the beginning of Habakkuk, he asked God, "God, why are you going to sit down and see people being dead, you know, people killing each other? Why are you going to sit down and see the injustice happening in this world?" He was mad with God. And the Lord spoke to Habakkuk and told Habakkuk, "I'm not just quiet. I can see it. My brother, stop complaining. I see it. I have a plan." And Habakkuk was like, "What kind of plan do you have, God?" He was challenging God. And God was faithful to tell him, "My brother, if you know the plan that I have for you, you should not ask for it. Because I am going to bring another tribe that will come and destroy you." Woo! And Habakkuk was like, "Oh God, I knew you are merciful, God. When then are you going to bring our enemies, people who don't believe in you, to come and destroy us?" You ask for it. Amen. Habakkuk, you ask for it. But the God, but our father also told him, "My brother, I know you are complaining. I know that 2019 things didn't work very well. It's not the way you planned it. But let me tell you that the vision that you have, the dream that you still have, I will make it come true immediately. But I am your God." He was told, "Light this vision, make it plain, interpret, so that you can see it. Other people can see it. The world can see it. Because at the end of the day, it will happen." Praise the Lord. If there's somebody that was trusting God so much for something in 2019, for the last 10 years, you're trusting God something and it never happened, the Lord says that it's still in the crowd. It will happen. It may have taken time, but trust me, it will happen. Amen?
Amen.
So the prophetic words that the Lord gave me, it may not have numbers this time, Jerry, but what I'm going to do, I'm going to preach through it, and I want somebody to start receiving some word in this house. Amen. And this is not only for this house, because there are people who are internationally receiving the word from this altar here, and every time they receive it, they learn with it. Mix it with the faith. Amen. You don't want it to be prophesied here, and then somebody comes from outside and prophesied that I received it, and you are here and you did not mix it with faith. Amen. So 2020, I'll start. 2020 is a starting of a new decade where the Lord will renew his covenant with his people. There will be restoration of broken dreams and vision throughout the body of Christ. I see the Lord restoring his glory and the power to the church. Amen. 2020 will be the year of double-double. As you see, 2020. So everything will be double-double. Whatever you're asking the Lord for, as it appears in the Lord, as it appears twice, the Lord will release tangible blessings twice. Just keep praying for them. Amen. So if you're trusting God, let me tell you, some people, maybe you're trusting God for a baby. The Lord will surprise you with a twin. Amen. It's double-double. Amen. You're trusting God for a house. The Lord will give you a house and give you another rental house. Amen. Praise the Lord. You're trusting God for a car. The Lord will not only give you one car, but the Lord will give you another one and another one in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. It's going to be double-double this year. The Lord will surprise his people. Amen. 2020 will be the year of great vision. Therefore, the Lord will open your eyes to see the hidden treasures, opportunities, and greatness that you have never discovered. There will be clarity in every area of your life. Increase your prayer life and you'll be amazed. Amen. There will be an amazing international relationship as this church continues to grow. The Lord will connect you globally. There will be major international networking in the areas of ministry, business, international studies, where some people will even have exchange program, and the talent recognition program international. So you better receive that one and work on it. Amen. God will grant someone, it better be me, amen. God will grant somebody debt-free homes. Debt-free homes. I know you guys think about mortgage all the time, but the Lord is faithful to grant someone debt-free homes. The scripture will be fulfilled in your eyes as you dwell in the houses that you did not build, and inherit business that you did not even labor to start. God will grant you unmerited favor. Be humble and give him the glory. Amen. Amen. Your gift, for somebody here, your gift will open the door for you to minister and to dine with the great servants of God and men in authority. May you continue to be humble. If that's you, may you continue to be humble, because this will be the beginning of a great journey to you, toward your great and mighty destiny. Amen. Amen. So if it's you, the Lord opened that door for you, please continue to be humble. Amen. Because this is just a beginning of a great journey. Amen. Don't run away from church because you died with the great people. This is just the beginning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Because just continue to be humble. Interact with other people here. If the Lord made you a celeb over here, it's okay, amen. You can come and worship here, amen. We are celeb to praise the Lord. So don't just run away because the Lord elevated you. Hallelujah. Another thing that the Lord will do in this house, chronic condition will be resolved. Chronic condition will be resolved or healed, both physical and emotional condition. As I talk here, there are people who have some chronic condition. Some of you is physically, you have struggled with it, and others is something that is emotionally, and some people are aware and others are not aware. But by God's grace, those one will be healed in this year 2020 in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. And this is what I saw. I said, the Lord says, I see the angel of the Lord. I see the angel of the Lord escorting you from that prison, as he did to Peter in the book of Acts, chapter number 12 and verse number 9. Amen. I see the Lord escorting somebody, the angel of the Lord escorting you from that prison. In Jesus' name. Amen. And guess what was happening? When Peter was escorted from the prison by the angel, the church was praying. Amen. So the church has to continue to pray for the Lord to start escorting people from the prison in Jesus' mighty name. Out of the prison, you'll be escorted. Amen. And that's physical and spiritual. Do you know somebody who is in prison? Let's start praying for them, for the Lord to escort them free. Do you know somebody who is in the spiritual? Some of you talking about the physical. It could be a family member. It could be somebody that you know. They are in prison. The Lord will escort them free. And some of you could be spiritual. You are bound. The Lord will escort them out of that prison in Jesus' name. Amen. There will be a double portion of anointing in the areas of the ministry. And one of the Lords clearly said that he's going to do what he's going to do. He's going to give the spirit of Elisha in this house. May you desire to be one of them. The spirit of Elisha, who had a double portion of the anointing. And Elisha had favor in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And I pray that as the Lord leads the spirit of Elisha, that people will start recognizing you. People will see the anointing and people will love the anointing we have. In Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Wow. Can I hear a bigger amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So supernatural harvest is back again. Those who were recipients of supernatural harvest in 2019 will become answers and source of help to many. Rising from being employed to employers. Yeah. Hallelujah. Just be obedient to the Lord and do not be afraid to sow seeds as the Lord leads you. The harvesting ground of 2019 is still plenty, that the Lord will open your eyes and you see another area, you see great field for 2020. Amen. Amen. So that's what you're gonna see. The field will be plenty for 2020. And I see the Lord say that some people that received supernatural harvest 2019 to become an answer for somebody. You start to become an employer in this house. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What is this that is too hard for our God? Amen. If the Lord calls you a senior, you better start claiming it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Listen to this. There will be a major numerical increase. Numerical increase. In ministry, here the SEC, families, hallelujah, kids will be born,
yes.
And people will host other people, and in your circle of influence, make room in your life to accommodate others.
That's true.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You got to move from that cocoon of yourself. Make room so that you can accommodate others. Like Hannah, the Lord will open physical and the spiritual wombs in this house. I see the Lord turning desert to a garden and making highways into wilderness. Just learn how to relate with other people because you will need them that one along the way. I don't know why the Lord is insisting so much about you learning how to live with other people. Amen. Maybe for the last 10 years, you've never known how to relate with others. I pray that the Lord God will help you, that you may know how to relate with others. Amen?
Amen.
Talk about money. Financial freedom and breakthroughs. May Jehovah cause recognition and favors from unexpected sources. The Lord will bless and multiply your resources. The Lord will help rebuke the defaulers on your behalf. May you learn the secret of giving. And that's how you know that the prophetic word. This is a prophetic Sunday. And I'm surprised because my sister Justine, when she came here, she talked about the secret of giving. So that's how you know that there's a prophetic. If the Lord, people are flowing in the prophecy. It's a prophetic Sunday. That's why my brother came here and talked about whatever you got here, you mix it with the faith. It's a prophetic sign that things are flowing prophetically in this house. So may you learn the secret of giving, financial freedom and breakthrough. And one thing that I said that may Jehovah cause recognition from and favor from unexpected sources. Amen? Amen. See, sometimes we just expect things from the sources that we know. But the Lord will make sure that you get from unexpected sources. If he was able to feed Elijah through leaven, the Lord will make sure that he will feed you through unexpected sources in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen? Amen? Listen to this one. This is a word for somebody. I don't know who you are, but this is a specific word for somebody. Someone who have not experienced peace. And I put the word peace in capital letters. Somebody who have not experienced peace for the last 10 years will have a major shift this decade. May the peace of God that surpasses all human understanding be upon your life. Amen?
Amen.
That's a long time for somebody that have not experienced peace for the last 10 years, but there's a major shift that will come in your life and you will experience peace that surpasses all human understanding. Amen?
Amen?
And this is for the church, not only here at JICC. This is a global ministry. My sister talked about the Lord elevating us to global when she was praying over here. And listen to this. Church, pray for the world peace. You pray for the peace in the world. This year as we start, there will be some unexpected instabilities in the world. There will be some turmoil in the political areas, both local and international, but the work of the church, the body of Christ here at JICC, is to pray and to pray and to pray. Amen? For the perfect will of God to be done. I see the prayers of the saint as a sweet aroma that will bring peace to the world. So the peace of the world is not with the world leaders, but the peace of the world, the solution to the world problem will be through the church. So church, do not let the political uncertainty dilute your faith. Do not let hatred infiltrate through the body of Christ. Continue to pray. Amen? So when you see the instability in the world, when you see the instability in your country, when you see the instability in Africa and any other places in the Middle East, your work is to pray and to pray and to pray. Continue to pray. Amen? I see someone. This is a word for somebody. It may not be for our teenagers, but this is for somebody. I see someone who went through a very, very, the Lord repeated twice. I see somebody who went a very, very bitter divorce. Those wounds are still fresh in you. I see the Lord healing you so fast and connecting you with a spouse that will be there for you forever. You will beat all the odds and many people will be surprised. Amen?
Amen.
And we'll know it when this happens. Amen? We'll be faithful. You'll see the testimony in this house when this happens. Amen? You'll get to know somebody. This is something. Get ready for this one, church. It's getting deeper, amen? It's 2020. You better be ready for it, amen? You get to know someone that you did not know that they existed in your family. Amen? Wow. May the Lord grant you the grace and humility to accept and love them unconditionally. Thank God that they are still alive. Amen?
Amen.
I don't know who they are. I don't know what it is. But let me repeat it again so that you may hear. You will get to know someone that you did not know that they existed in your family. Amen? God is full of wonders. May the Lord God grant the grace and humility to accept and love them unconditionally. Thank God they are still alive.
Amen.
I don't want you to say amen. It's from the Lord. Amen? I'm just a person to deliver the word. Amen? Hallelujah. Wow. See how God works. Some things started happening even when we came here for the overnight on 31st. Those people who are with me here can bear witness as I leave this one. There will be a major deliverance that will take place in this altar. There will be a major deliverance that will take place in this altar. The spirit of alcoholism will be broken. Can I repeat it again? Yes. The spirit of alcoholism will be broken. And sometimes people say in church, oh, you see people dressed up, you see people who are looking good, you say, oh, they don't drink alcohol. Those people who are here in Kesha, one of the men came and testified and he said that he was bound by the spirit of alcoholism. And he was delivered. So the more the spirit of alcoholism will be broken, substance abuse, pride will melt, and other addiction will be broken in Jesus' mighty name. Sometimes people don't need to be here physically. You just need a point of contact and mention their name here, and the power of God will locate them wherever they are. Praise the Lord. That's how powerful it will be. I see people who will be coming here with their handkerchief and their pictures of their loved one. You bring them and just put them in this altar. Pray for them. And when you leave, you go there believing God. And wherever they are, they may not even be here in this country, but they will be delivered in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You saw it happening last year where this young couple here came with a dirt, the soil, and they trusted God for a house. Amen. And by the end of the day, they seek a house supernaturally in Jesus' name. That is exactly that things that are going to be happening here in Jesus' name. Oh, amen.
Amen.
This might be a better one. Amen. So I know you guys are getting scared, but we are almost there. Amen. I see the Lord lacing kids or teens, millionaire that you know very well. Amen. I better start praying and fasting. Amen. I see the Lord raising kids or a teen millionaire that you know very well.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know how. I don't know whether they're going to win a lotto. I don't know whether it's their talent. I don't know whatever source. But somebody that you know very well, the Lord will raise them as a kid millionaire. Amen.
Amen.
Wow. This one, there will be a major family reunion. Amen. There will be a major family reunion.
Yes.
The enmity for the last decade will be resolved by God's grace.
Amen.
May you enjoy the family when they are still alive.
Amen.
Amen. Because you don't want to see them at the graveside, you better enjoy them. They're still alive. You better enjoy them when they're still alive. They may not be the perfect people that you like to see, but guess what? Enjoy them when they're still alive. They may be getting back to your nerve, to the last nerve, but they're still your family. Amen? Enjoy them. Amen. Can I repeat that one again? There will be a major family reunion. The enmity for the last decade will be resolved by God's grace. May you enjoy your family when they are still alive. Amen?
Amen.
I see, well, this one here. I see the Lord breaking the umbilical cord of someone who has been tied by the power of witchcraft, bitterness, anger, and fear. I see the Lord breaking the umbilical cord of someone that has been tied by the power of witchcraft, bitterness, anger, and fear. You will finally experience a new life in Christ. And you are going to be influential. And your influence will be so great to the church. When everything is broken, you will experience a new life in Christ. And you'll be a person of influence to the church. Amen?
Amen.
And some of these things, they require a lot of counseling and they require a lot of prayers because some people and some things people do not know. Amen? There are people who may be tied by the power of witchcraft, bitterness, anger, and fear, and you may not even recognize it. But I pray that it will be broken in Jesus' mighty name. Amen? Then, just like 2019,
There will be God-driven marriages in this and stable relationship in the body of Christ. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Woo. God-driven marriages in this altar, and there will be relationships, stable relationship in the body of Christ. And 2020 will be your year of portion, and the Lord will hold your heart in this year 2020. He will walk with you, and He will bless you. Amen. Amen. So I see a new decade that is starting with greatness. But most important, the Lord will open your eyes. It's going to be the year of great vision. In Jesus' name. I want you to focus on your heart. I want you to focus on your mind. And I want you to tell God that you are ready for this year 2020. Take time and worship God. Take time and talk to God.
Holy Spirit of God, Holy Spirit.